In previous videos, we've looked at how to create an alarm indicator on a graphics page using bindings and conversions. Now let's try to do the same thing in a more flexible way with JavaScript and investigate how the language interacts with our project. I'm going to create a simple numerical display that turns red when the displayed value is over a set point. Just as you would expect, I'll place a text object, and bind its content. The bind's name doesn't matter at the moment. We're going to stay inside preview mode for this exercise. I'll also add a script object to the text, which is where this section really begins. Inside the script object, there are different behaviors and the script's content. If I enter a name for a behavior, that creates an empty function in the content. I can trigger events on various mouse actions, when the page is first loaded, or more importantly at the moment, when a bound signal changes in the associated object. For this behavior, I'll create a function called signal. I can click the ellipsis button to the side to open the edit dialog, where I see the function's definition. When that signal change occurs, the page calls the associated behavior function and passes it an event object. This is a custom event based on the web API, and it is documented in the system guide. Let's start by looking at the value that the signal passes. In the function, I'll call the log function of the standard console object to display the value of the event. To test this, from the View menu, open the Console pane. I like to drag it to the side so I have it open alongside the Test pane. Now I can go to Preview mode. If I enter a value to test, it shows up in the console. I'll use this log function frequently to test and debug JavaScript functions. Back in my function, most scripts will eventually need to retrieve or modify an attribute in the TGML file. For that, we'll start with a target element. The event object actually has two targets. evt.getTarget is the element that triggered the event. For a signal change, it's the binding whose value changed. For a mouse event, it's the element that was clicked or moved over. evt.getCurrentTarget, however, is always the parent element of the script itself. Let's verify the tag names of both of these in the log. As you can see, getTarget is pointing to the bind tag, while getCurrentTarget points to the text. Finally, we need to do something with this script. I want my text to change red if the value is over 100 and blue otherwise, and we now have the tools to do so. The text color is held in the stroke attribute, and the value is this hex string. So my function is now, if evt.getValue is greater than 100, evt.getCurrentTarget.setAttribute stroke pound FF0000 for red. Else, evt.getCurrentTarget.setAttribute stroke pound 0000 FF for blue. If I jump over to the preview, you can see that this works correctly. Congratulations! You have now created a simple script that mimics a binding with a pair of convert value objects. However, we've just scratched the surface. Next, we'll see how we can pass this script some parameters and save it as a snippet. Until then, thank you.